Hi everyone, it's Thomas DOTD with another video. The last few months I have been working on a lot of custom models, and that might interest you, as so many were interested in my Origins James and LBSC Thomas models. In my 75th anniversary pitch video, I said that a Lionel Gordon, while it would look really interesting, would be far too expensive to produce and expensive to sell. But what if I told you I have been making an O-gauge Gordon for years? And the only reason it took so long was because it was just so expensive to make. Well, without further ado, let's take a look at the O-gauge Gordon. Oh, wait a minute. That's the 00 Hornby Gordon. Oh wait, give me a minute here. There we go, the O-gauge Gordon. Now, making Gordon took years to finish simply because so much had to be done to get all the pieces. It was very expensive. It all started in 2016 when Brendan Reese 10 went to a train show and someone was selling an O-gauge Flying Scotsman shell with a coach. Brendan, being the amazing friend that he is, actually kept the coach but gave me the Scotsman pieces after I paid him. After that, we decided to meet up for the summer and paint the model blue to look like Gordon. In theory, it seemed like an easy project, but as you can see with this very old video, the chassis did not fit, it didn't run, and was using a standard Lionel chassis. It just looked ugly. Not to mention that while Brendan and I worked hard spray painting the blue, I unfortunately rushed doing the pinstriping, which made the whole thing just look sloppy. Basically, it just wasn't a very good model. Paint was applied poorly, the chassis was ugly, it really needed to be redone. For years, I simply let the project sit on the back burner as I looked for a suitable O-gauge chassis. Rather than using Lionel, I was thinking of getting a British two-rail chassis, but yeah, take a look at some of these prices. And don't say, oh, go to a second-hand seller or store. This is a second-hand seller. Sure, I always had the option to just make a custom chassis, but I can't do that. I have no idea where to even begin with something like that. For years, it seemed like I'd never get this model done. Until recently, however. Some time ago, I began buying the Hornby Thomas models, as I really do like the look of them. Except Edward. I took my Gordon shell out again and noticed it was almost identical to the Hornby Gordon. And after searching online and getting some measurements, I found that Lionel's Hogwarts Express chassis would be a perfect fit for the shell. The only downside of the chassis is that the side rods aren't super accurate, but I didn't want to focus on going super accurate. I just wanted to make a cool model. And I think that's important to remember. Every model I make for myself. They all have their pros and cons, and I know some love to critique, but at the end of the day, if I'm the one spending all this money and I'm happy, I'm just gonna continue being happy, honestly. Some have suggested swapping out the side rods, but let me tell you this much, if it hasn't been done by now, there's a reason it's not getting done. Anyways, it was time for a fresh start. I sanded Gordon down and grabbed a light blue spray paint to match the cute baby blue of the Hornby models. Can't forget his tender. I think it dried very nicely. Then it was time to add different colors such as black, red, and white. As I waited for the rest to dry, I began painting the chassis. I also added Gordon's back wheel, which was not on the original Hogwarts Express. And let's take the time to redo the pinstriping and make it look as nice as I can get it. Time to add his number 4. And after that, Gordon was finished. This was honestly so much fun to make, and I think it really shows that patience, even if it is prolonged patience, really helps to make sure whatever project you're working on is the best you can make it. I also think that making O-gauge models based off the Hornby models is a pretty cool idea. While I am working on Railway Series models based off the early book illustrations, and I have the O-gauge Strasbourg Thomas on the way, let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more Hornby-styled O-gauge models. I'm so glad I finally finished this model, and I think it really opens the door for what kind of videos I can make by adding more characters to the O-Gage range. This just goes to show that if Lionel found a way to make a new body tooling, they can make a Gordon using the Hogwarts Express chassis and parts. This would really change a lot for the 75th anniversary range. Now, the great thing about making these videos and showing my methods to all of you is that now, if any of you are determined enough, you could make an O-Gage Gordon too. Because while I like how my model looks, he's certainly not perfect. There are significant areas of improvement to be found, but that's what I love about this community. We can all make a model of the exact same character, but all of us will find a way to make every model look distinct. My O-Gage Gordon is not perfect, but I'm okay with that. But I have no doubt that any of you could have a go at making an O-Gage Gordon, and one day, some creator will come around and make the perfect Gordon for O-Gage. I can't wait for whenever that day comes around. Anyways, this has been Thomas DOTD, and I hope to see you all again really soon.